Hi everyone, it's your boy, it's Pixelotties, and today, apologies for the very bad camera quality and filming location. I am currently filming this on my floor, and just to spice things up and make things look cute, I took something from my old scrapbook kit thingy, and yeah, so that's settled. Today I'm going to be showing y'all some old art from 2016. I did say that this is gonna be cringy, and well, let's get on to it. Things first, you are greeted with the cover of my sketchbook, Watch Me Fail. Isn't that a really welcoming introduction? Yes, so, yep, then we got the second introduction, that, yes. And this is just a bunch of OCs. Hold on, let me zoom in. These are my OCs, Vanessa and 4Cs. I don't know if that's how you pronounce that name, it's Greek, but yeah. And she's a succubus and she's an incubus, and they're siblings. Demon siblings. This one's just a marker practice thing. I was testing my aquarelle markers, and you know, I like this color, not bad. This one, just a random doodle of my OCs. They're part of Headerville, which is a story that I'm currently showing on Instagram through short comics. And oh my god, what I don't like about my old art is the fact that I don't use the paper. Like, I don't use it as a whole. There's like spaces here that should have been used, but now I have this urge to like just draw on it, even though I'm done with the sketchbook. This one, emotion practice. Not bad. Another one with the acryl markers. Yes, see what I'm talking about? You see that? This could have been used really well if young me didn't decide to like, okay, I'm gonna draw. Oh, psych, let's move on to the next page. I don't want that. Okay, then we got OCs, more marker practice. Sylvie, I actually really like this. I used to color like that. Like, I would color with markers and then shade it with fabric pastel colored pencils. They're really good for shading. There's Angelica from Hamilton. I got into Hamilton in 2016, and it was the first musical that I got into. Look at that, same face syndrome. Very delicious, don't you agree? Yes. And this is just a request from Wattpad. Watercolor practice. I used a bunch of cheap watercolors. Amanita, also a character from Heatherville. Yeah, just me planning for an animation. Yeah. And then an OC, the Gravity Falls OC to be specific, that I was gonna use for a Wattpad roleplay, but I don't know what happened to that roleplay. It didn't really work out well, as all Wattpad roleplays do. This one's just my friend's birthday. Yeah, it's a gift. These are OCs and they're adorable. This one is just a practice. Like, back then, I thought aquarelle markers are the same as alcohol markers. And I was like, oh, I'm gonna try and blend them, like in those aesthetic Copic marker videos. And when I did that, I was very confused. Like, oh, it's not blending well. So I decided to make this. It's not that bad, I guess. But I was expecting it to be like smooth and gradient-like, you know, like in those aesthetic Copic videos. Hamilton. I don't know what this is. It's supposed to be dynamic, but I'm just, you know, confused. This one's practice, yeah. Amanita, angsty. This one's what I did with my acryl markers, not bad as well. Oh gosh, she be reaching the heavens though. I really don't understand why I keep drawing people with very long necks. I'm trying to get rid of that though. Color Switch, she's my pony sauna, and her cutie mark are primary colors. Those aren't primary colors. Those aren't primary colors. This one's... okay, this one's actually a pretty funny story. I was drinking from my glass. It has a tint, it's colored and whatnot. And the color is actually shedding. In those sheddings, I saw like this dude who looks like he has like a goat tail and whatnot. And then there's this girl who seems to be like levitating something around. And then there's one that looks like she has a snake tail. So I drew those, and out of these three, this girl actually... yeah, I draw this girl more. These guys, they're forgotten. Like all my other OCs, honestly. You flip this page and you are greeted by someone with a breadstick legs, breadstick feet. My gosh, where are your toes? And this one's PJO fan art. I was really into Percy Jackson at the time. Cobalt, the girl from earlier. That's her. Yes. This one, she's also an OC of mine, but she's a background character in Heatherville. And her name, it used to be Ellen, but now it's Lauren. These are her goldfish twins. And you can see them in my Instagram post. I still draw goldfish like that. Vent art. Yeah, one time my teacher flipped through my sketchbook and that was the first thing he saw. Yes. He was my Bible studies teacher. This one. Yes, OC is... Glitchtail, I was really into Glitchtail. Yes, I was a huge Undertale trash back then. I don't want to talk about that. This one's Hamilton, yeah, satisfied. Wow, look at it. Yes, this one's supposed to be like my OCs in Heatherville, like Livia, Sylvie, Amanita. They are like dressed up in those 30s attire, if I'm not mistaken. Is it 30s? Yeah, basically... Grandma culture. This one was made with the same watercolors as this. It's owned by a relative of mine, and those are really good watercolors, so that's good paint, so I tried it. Oh my god, this one, this was Yuri on Ice, is actually the one of the first few animes that got me into anime, but it was, you know, it took me a while, but yeah, Yuri on Ice, it was good. Oh my gosh, it's good. I absolutely love it. What's wrong with her scalp? Oh my god, what's wrong with her scalp? This one was made with Staedtler colored pencils. I'm gonna say it. They are bad, and I don't know if it's because of the kind of pencil that I got, but you literally have to like color it like deeply, like scratch that on the paper, and literally you can't get it darker than that. That's the darkest it can get, and I'm already like doing that to the paper, and it's very bland. That's why I only use them for like sketching and whatnot, since it's pretty light. But till this day, I don't know why they're like that. My classmates in real life, I drew them because they asked me to. August, again, I keep on trying to draw dynamic poses, but I literally don't know what's happening. Like, Mariah, she's another OC of mine in the universe of Heatherville. Yeah, I keep drawing a lot of Heatherville stuff, mainly because that's the story that I was focused on during 2016. She's supposed to be like a singer Cyclops thingy, because you know how Cyclops change voices? Like, they can imitate voices, and I'm like, what if a Cyclops becomes a singer? So, like, they be famous because they can literally do Keisha and they can do Shakira. This was something my friend made. Yeah. And this one, I was trying to go for, like, the doodling art style. You know that style where they just draw, like, random cute, tiny people? Yeah, that one. I don't know. Jinx Harlequin, she's my OC. And this is sort of what she currently looks like. But just add on a hat. And yeah, I really love drawing poofy gowns. Tiny legs. Yes. This chair, her weapon is like an umbrella. That does not look like an umbrella, that looks like a pole. And it has like a little tiny knife thingy at the end. And she stabby stabs with that. Yeah, cool weapon. This one's Eliza and Philip. Okay, let's move on because I'm gonna cry. This one's Jinx and another villain OC of mine. He's a bakhtak, and I don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly, but bakhtaks are actually mythical creatures that rest on, not really rest, they sit on people's chests. They're dummy thick thighs sitting on their chests. And what they do is they just kind of lay there and squash that person. And when you wake up and your chest feels heavy, that's because a dummy thick bakhtak decided to sit on your chest while you're sleeping. Fun. Oh god, another more of these dynamic poses. As you can see, even my 2016 self cannot cope with what's going on. Like, what is this? What is this? Then there's this really nice drawing. Yeah, I really like this, not gonna lie, I love it. And Keith Keith, it's this guy over here. His name is Keith. Yes. The angst page? No, crappy vent page. Sorry, not angst. It is just a crappy vent page. So let's just leave it at that. This one. I feel so bad for my alcohol markers. This is also the time I thought they were like alcohol markers. And you can see me trying my best to blend them. Not bad. More Amanita with the same gown. Yes. Keep on drawing her in that gown. Jinx, but I don't get it why she doesn't have the poofy skirt thing. Where is your poofy skirt thing? This is not Jinx. She's wearing a tinier skirt. This is so not her. I don't like her design. Ow. Bye. Pixel. This was made for my friend's markers. I was bored, so I decided to cringe. See, even my 2016 self knows that her art is cringe. This one's Ellen, now Lauren, and she went through a redesign, as you can see. Yeah, now that I think about it, she looks like a self-insert now. Like, it's like I just inserted myself in my own story, and now that I think about it, I think she was a self-insert. More OCs, yeah. Now that I think, oh my god, I draw feet the same way as I draw hands, and I don't know what to feel. They look like breadsticks. Breadsticks with bandages. Oh god. If I draw their hands like breadsticks, then what's this? I can draw decent hands, but I decided, oh no, he's gonna have breadstick hands because I'm lazy apparently. Then there's... I keep on using my friend's markers. Like, they're not even the same friend. Like, they're different friends with different markers. And I just sort of pluck those markers and use them. That's me. So keep your markers safe because I will chase you down and use them. This one's Sylvie, my another OC of mine. And another Amanita with the same gown. Pixel. More OC is this OC. I just drew her randomly while we were taking exams. And she looks like a cross between Darla Dimple and a peppermint. Till this day, I don't know why I drew her and why I decided to make her an OC. But yeah, this is the last time I actually used her and I never drew her again. Then we move to the next page and you got Hamilton. Yes. More of those watercolor practice things. I really don't know how to use watercolor at the time. I really don't know. Vent art. This one was made with one line. I actually really like that. Edgy. Nice. This one, yeah. I have a speed paint of that on my channel. It's the very first video I posted. Not exactly the first. I actually purged my YouTube account and deleted all my old videos before posting the speed paint. And I'm not gonna say what my old videos are. They were something else. This one's made with my friend's markers again. And then this one, random sketch. This was colored by one of my classmates because she was bored and I told her to color it because honestly, I really don't want to touch this sketch anymore. Yep. Valentine's art with a bunch of OCs. And then there's Pixel. Yeah. This one's, I actually really like this. Not bad. It looks cool. I should really start drawing with black backgrounds again. I will. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do this again because this looks really good. 100 over 10. This is actually the only thing I like in this sketchbook so far. This, okay, hold on. Camera quality. This is Pixel but as a cat. This one, just a request my friend gave me. She wanted me to draw this character from an anime she likes. I forgot the name, but yeah, I drew that. This page is just full of OCs that I never got to use again. Again, why am I not filling the empty spaces? I'm really having this urge to like just draw on this sketchbook even though I finished it already, just to fill up the empty spaces. Because it's such a waste. Veronica, yes. Heathers was the second musical I got into. This was me in my Ravenclaw robe. I didn't color that, but yep, I'm a Ravenclaw. This one is just to show the methods that I use, I don't know, when it comes to coloring. Like, it's either this, like I just shade, cross shade with, yeah, with a ball pen. This one is like full on, I color with markers, yeah. This one's colored with fabric pastel pencils. This one's colored with markers, and then I shaded with colored pencils. Yeah, I love this method. This is my favorite, actually, and I still use it sometimes. This one's, yeah, still the same thing. It's just full-on markers, but with a different style. And this one's with acrylics. I still paint the same way as I do right now. Like, literally nothing improved with the way I paint. And I don't know if that's a good thing or not. Of that Darla Dimple Peppermint Love Child girl. She was originally going to be part of Heatherville, and I kind of just like removed her from the plot because she literally has no relevance except fuel my ship. She's like the other woman or whatever. And to fuel my ship, the person I'm shipping August with is going to be like so jealous and everything, and they're going to fight Peppermint Love Child over here. So no, not really relevant to the plot, and it's pretty cringy, so I removed her. Bye, beach. This one is a scene from Percy Jackson. Yeah, let's leave it at that. Got Vincent here, an OC of mine, also part of Heatherville. He used to be a hot, edgy, ooh-woo vampire boy. Now, he's just Vincent. Just tired of life Vincent. And I'm proud of that redesign. This one is Ale. She's also an old OC of mine. I love the coloring. I actually really like this thing. Tallulah wasn't my first OC who rocked that poncho look. And now that I think about it, I want to redraw her again because I actually love her design. And this, a tree, and that's it. Thanks for reading. Oh! We got more. There we go. This one, this is actually a really good paper. You hear that? And oh my gosh, the back portion is completely blank! I can use it again. So, yes, I used my markers for this. Anyway, this one's Keith with different hairstyles. Okay, that's nothing to see there. This one's a contest entry. Like, in Wattpad, because like I follow this one artist and she held this contest wherein you should like draw your OC with their OC, and it's your choice which one of their OCs you want to draw. And I drew this guy because, yeah, Sylvie's a cat person and this guy's a wolf person, and I'm like, they fit, so I drew them. Yeah, this one's just something I made for Valentine's Day. I made this at the last minute, and I walked around the hallway showing this to people like, earn my love. Earn my love. They did. They earned my love. This one. More Darla Dimple Peppermint Girl crossover or whatever. This one's something I made. Yeah, with charcoal pencils. I draw their heads so big. Like, more of those breadstick hand and feet. Like, more of that. And then big head. That's even worse. This one's more old OCs. There's a lot of Lucy's that I don't use anymore. Math. Heatherville logo. Yeah, literally nothing changed in the Heatherville logo except... What is it? There's... This one. This is a redraw my friend did. I'll just show it here. There we go. She redrew that. This one... More Amanita. She keeps on wearing the gown. I literally did not draw her in her original design. In this sketchbook, like, nothing. It's just Amanita and her gown. This one, this was made, like, one time when we were practicing for graduation. And I just did that. What? Night in the Woods. I immediately know what it's about just by seeing the... Yes, Night in the Woods. This one. I actually really love the game. The soundtrack was fire. I love it so much. I didn't finish drawing the crocodile girl. Sad. She was also my favorite. But, you know, that's fine. This one. sticker. I didn't use it because it's still precious. But yeah, this is actually the first thing that I printed a sticker. My first ever sticker. And there's... I want to redraw this. I want to try and make stickers again. That's fun. I want to make stickers. This one, anatomy practice. This one, also the same time that I thought acrylic markers and alcohol markers are the same thing. I failed so bad. Oh gosh, that blending. The emoji challenge. I hosted this on Framecast. I showed this on Framecast. And basically, people give me emojis and I make characters out of them. This challenge is really good if you want to like squirt your creative juices. This is good when it comes to like character design. You want to practice different body types? Sure, go on ahead. And I don't know, it's just a really nice challenge. I still do it in my free time. So yeah. This one's the last thing here in this extension thingy. And this one is just my OC. Blake and Livia. This is not canon, by the way. I just really like shipping my OCs to cope with the fact that I'm single and no one will ever love me the same way as how my OCs will love each other. And then, what is going on? And that concludes the sketchbook tour. Thank you guys so much for watching me fail, and I hope you guys liked the video, and you know, even though I just showed y'all my cringy art, and that's pretty much it. Apologies again for the very bad camera quality. I hope you guys liked the video. Babush!